It's My Shout is a unique film training scheme in Wales. It supports upcoming actors, writers, directors, and crew in the production of short films for television. The scheme has been running for 10 years, and more than 9,000 trainees have now taken part in the production of over 60 short films. Today, hundreds of former trainees are working in the industry, both in front of and behind the camera. This is the story of It's My Shout. In 2003, Roger Bunnell was director of theatre for Bridgend Council. He launched a project for local young people to express themselves through making a short film.
We're going down Bloodstream! Anyone want to come with me?
I did feel that film might be a way to engage with these young people. The people who were working with me at that time felt that they'd probably want to deal with issues. It could be loneliness or drugs or... But no, they wanted to tell a story. And they wanted to create a story. They wanted to create characters. They wanted to create a sense of excitement. And drama.
The result was a film called Down, about a boy's quest to solve the mystery behind his friend's disappearance. Emma Housley was one of Down's leading cast members.
It's been nearly 2 weeks.
She's now performing on London's West End.
Look.
No one's gonna... I played the part of Sian, which was a friend of the two people, like the girl that was murdered and the young boy that was trying to find out what happened. But there was one line that continues to stick with me, and it's basically, I'm walking with the lead character, the young boy, and the line is, it's just not right, is it? But back then, with my accent being a lot stronger, it came out, it's just not right, is it?
So, will you come with me, Em?
No way. Sorry, Alex. It's just not right, is it?
The general feel of the whole project, I just remember it being really exciting and really, you know, fun, and everyone couldn't wait to do it and couldn't wait to get to the next stage of the project. Since Down, I obviously carried on at school to my A-levels, but then after that, I went on to study at the Arts Educational School in London and then got into The Wizard of Oz, which is the job I'm doing now. And I'm first cover Dorothy, but when I'm not playing Dorothy, I'm a Munchkin and I'm in Emerald City and, you know, doing everything backstage, singing and everything like that. It's really great.
Liam Riddick also took part in Down. He's currently rehearsing for a national tour with the Richard Alston Dance Company.
I'd never been on, like, not a film set, but I'd never been on that kind of environment before. And even though it was, I remember it being quite low key, but it was quite small. But I was fascinated to see all the cameras and the locations and everything taken from the piece of paper and put into real life. That's the best memory I think I take away. Like, forget the film and everything, to be a part of the making of it and the creation was the best bit for me.
Yeah, I think that's probably why it worked. They wanted just to have to tell their story as a story. And you shouldn't go to new talent and young talent and tell them how to do something. That should come from them.
The following year, the project grew to make three more short films with young people throughout Bridgend.
It's midnight, the witching hour. They've drunk their love potions and I just have to cast their spells on their victims.
Amy Morgan first became involved in 2004 and is now working on London's West End.
So let me get this right. You're looking for a husband?
Yes, that's correct.
So why have you come here?
I was never one of those people that said, oh, I've always wanted to be an actress. I actually wanted to be an air hostess. And then I found out that I was too short to ever be an air hostess. And so gave up on that one. But I just remember Roger Bunnell, who runs the Bridgend Youth Theatre as well, asking a couple of us if we wanted to audition for these short films and things. Yeah, okay, fine, great, sounds brilliant. And I remember the first one was that I did anyway, that was called Bertus Pasty, which was very interesting. And it was like a teenage party, and I remember it was the first set that I'd ever been on, and it was incredible. You just didn't want to touch anything, but everything was disgusting because it was a party. And so you had, you know, the props lady had done cigarettes stubbed out in beer cans and things, and you were like, oh God, this is brilliant, but it's disgusting. And yeah, I remember being given one line. That was a lot of pressure at the time. Didn't want to get it wrong. Probably did get it wrong a couple of times.
Is it true what Lindsay said?
What true?
About you and that maths teacher. Slag.
I think I did 3 films with It's My Shout, maybe 1 or 2 more, because I always had little bits here and there, or Roger would call up and say, well, you've got, can you do this? Because somebody can't make it or whatever. So I think it was 3. And one of those I did when I was still training at a Royal Welsh College in Cardiff. Since leaving drama school, I've done some BBC Wales productions. I did a thing called Baker Boys that was on. I did 2 series of that.
Whoa, you're alive.
When was the last time I looked, yeah?
Oh, we've all been so worried about Vali Barra and you, obviously.
Obviously. Is he in?
Not yet. There were 400... and 19 calls while you were away. I took messages. Coffee?
And I've done a lot of theatre, actually. The last couple of plays I've done have been in London, which has been nice. It's My Shout was absolutely invaluable to me in terms of the discipline on set and the etiquette on set and things like that. I seem to have much more of a head start. Me and the couple of people in my year group at Welsh College, when we were doing our TV project, we knew so much more than we thought we knew, and that, you know, people were telling us things that we already knew and we didn't even realise we had that knowledge. It was already in us from what we'd done with It's My Shout. You know, we all had quite big ambitions for the film scheme, and I know Rog always had big ambitions for it. He sort of really saw it going as far as it possibly could, which was brilliant.
The scheme became known as It's My Shout, giving a voice and opportunity for young people to develop their talents, whether in front of or behind the camera. Griff Rowland directed It's My Shout's first Welsh language film in 2004. Today, he's a director on Coronation Street.
I saw Ryan this morning.
Well, I've been doing a lot of documentary work at BBC Wales for a good few years. I had trained in drama, in theory and practice at Central School of Speech and Drama. And to be honest with you, I wanted to go back to direct drama for television. And so it was quite a bit of a jump, because people like to just pigeonhole you as just one thing, or a documentary maker, or like a drama director, or, you know, a comedy. And I just had to make that jump. My short film that I'd done for Roger and It's My Shout led me to, for my first professional gig, if you like, as a drama director, working on Cowboys Like Injuns for S4C. Well, at the moment, I'm now directing Coronation Street. This is my 51st episode. And then once I finish this block, then I'm going to do the Christmas Day episode. So I'm thrilled. I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing now if it wasn't for having done that short film. So I know it's absolutely instrumental in that jump I wanted in my career and the change of direction.
Year on year, the scheme expanded into more communities across South and West Wales. Sony has been It's My Shout's biggest supporter throughout.
The growth of It's My Shout is very impressive growth, starting from something that very much was a local theme with local people, and now we are starting to put people on a much wider scale, growing it to the size of covering all of Wales, reaching out to far more communities than just the Bridge End. So it's an absolutely tremendous scheme that's grown probably much more than I had envisaged from the very beginning.
It's My Shout's main broadcast sponsor is now BBC Wales, who offer industry guidance and a broadcast platform for all the films.
For many people, television production, filmmaking can feel outside, beyond their grasp. And I think It's My Shout gives people the confidence to make the connections, to stand that little bit taller in those conversations, and with a conviction that they have something valuable to say or do. It's really important in television that the range of perspectives, the range of voices that take part in production come from the widest possible field. We, you know, the BBC is owned by the licence fee payer. It's owned by every community across Wales. And it's important that every community across Wales believes it has the right to be able to think about participating in television production and know those avenues are open to everybody and not just the few.
Since 2006, the scheme has produced 6 films each summer in partnership with schools, colleges and local authorities across Wales. In 2011, it reached Bangor in North Wales, where it filmed ABC Dad.
I could help you learn if you want.
Well, at the time, it was something that was more to do with it down in Bridgend, and I was lucky enough to be living locally, if you like, from, you know, I live in Cardiff, but I come from Bangor, and now that It's My Shout has gone to North Wales, I'm so pleased to see North Wales films, because, you know, it's part of Wales, you know, and like I think last year's, I'm so nice to see like sort of one location, which is like sort of the corner shop next to my school that I went to. I thought, and it's great because actually the opportunity it gives people from all over Wales is really important, I think, because the voices of Wales come from each corner.
I think it's vital that we continue to look for the talent and continue to develop the talent that might otherwise be lying dormant.
You thought I should be tough?
Fight!
Justin Davis had never acted before playing the lead role in the 2010 film Be a Man.
Well, the first time I heard about It's My Shout is when they came to my school about 2 years ago now, and my drama teacher picked people who's doing like well or okay in the subject to go to a talk with Roger, and he told us all about It's My Shout. And then Roger was doing like a workshop with us then. He was giving us scenarios, and I think it was a synopsis to one of the short films, and we had to act it out how we would.
The bus is well late.
It always is. She looking.
Well, we got asked to then go to an audition down in Bridgend, and this was me and my mum's like version of, oh, we're going to Hollywood. But really, it was only like 40 miles down the M4. But I can remember telling my friends that, oh, I went for an audition down Bridgend for a short film on BBC Wales, and I was waiting for the call for quite some time, and then I didn't hear nothing for quite a while. Then, funny enough, when I was out with my friends one day, I got a call off my mum, who found out off Roger that I've got one of the leading parts.
Go on, then. Stop him, eh? Go on. Get into him.
Kick him.
Aye. Break his legs.
Smash him.
That's it, yes. Go on. Go on, yes. Yes. Oh, go on, champion.
It was the first time we'd ever been on a television set, and it felt really weird because it was in surroundings that I'd never been in before, never seen the people before, and it was just quite a weird experience because
there's probably about 30 people crammed into a two-bedroom house in the middle of Ebervale, and you're thinking, gosh, what are all these people here for? You know, everybody had a role to play, whether it was in front of the camera or behind the camera. It was really intense and amazing.
Yeah. A couple of weeks after Be A Man came out, it was just nothing. It was just like, oh, I've done that now. Just get on with life. But then I went into school one day and I got told to go see my drama teacher. And she told me, she said, she had a phone call that I've got an audition for Ruth Jones' Sky One new programme, Stella.
Ben, I have made you like a...
Yeah, go on.
I have made you a week. Type of thing.
She haven't done it.
A wheat cheese.
Yes.
The dress rehearsals are full.
I know, and I'll bring it up to school.
When?
This afternoon.
When?
At 3 o'clock.
When?
Even though 2 years, that does sound like a long time. So much has happened. It just feels like yesterday that it all started. And now we're currently in the middle of filming series 2. It's just mad how my life has changed in such a short period of time.
The It's My Shout project gave him the opportunity to develop and perhaps identify a career path that he wouldn't have thought of before. I think the whole thing about the It's My Shout project, it is that it has created opportunities for young people across the board. We're sat here in the middle of Six Bells in Blaenau Gwent, and Blaenau Gwent has been continuously slated in the press for being a deprived, a depressed, a run-down area. But as you can see, it's not deprived, it's not depressed, it's not run-down. And the fact that It's My Shout has provided opportunities for the young people of the area to take part and to identify what their goals and dreams are and ultimately to succeed, I think is a testament to the It's My Shout project and what it's all about.
King Danny needed to rescue the old king from his dungeon. The Beast!
Thomas Herbert got his first lead role in King of the Castle in 2011.
Before doing It's My Shout, I thought it was just people living out their lives and they just happened to be on a TV screen. But then when I did It's My Shout, I was thinking, you don't just live out your life. There's a script and stuff, and you have to learn it.
Why aren't you eating any?
It's not hungry.
I'll save some chips, just in case you want them later.
Since It's My Shout, I got a part in a short film, and I've done a Maggie advert, which I had to have fake teeth for. And then I did a Pets at Home advert. Then I did Casualty.
Hey, Thomas, how are you doing?
It was really fun working down in the BBC studio because I had my own dressing room, and it was really cool because there was a green room and you got to watch TV there whenever you liked.
Ryan Andrews and Kerry Collins were trainee directors and have recently finished work on their debut feature films.
When I directed Be A Man for It's My Shout, that was the first time I'd worked under a BBC exec producer directly, and the first time I'd had to fit in with the editorial guidelines of the BBC, and the process is different to making independent film. So that was the first time I'd ever had to do that, which was an invaluable learning experience.
Before I worked on It's My Shout, the projects I'd been working on were music videos or adverts or promotional work, or shorts I'd put together myself and worked on my own crew. So It's My Shout was great to go into like more of a professional environment where you're given a script that you have to direct, which isn't yours and you know nothing about, but you're chosen because of your directing style. I was given a short called Family Picnic, which was a really sweet short about two kids that didn't have very loving parents. And it was set pretty much in reality, you know, a normal kind of like realist environment. And I thought what I could give to that script was that I set it in a different world. So I kind of set it in a steampunk world.
It's okay. I got it.
The short film format is really, really tough. It's a hard thing to do, and it's an art in itself. It's completely different from making feature films. You have so much less time. Generally, you have less money. And, you know, it's a really, really tough thing to do. So, you know, short films offer such an important part of any filmmaker's career because it's the only thing you can do to move on to feature films, because no one's going to give you, you know, a six-figure sum to make a feature film if you've never directed anything.
So as a first step for a director, it's brilliant because you're not only being supported, but you do get an end product that is a certain level, which everyone needs. You have to start building your portfolio of products that exist within a reality of the industry. And I think It's My Shout is a great one to that. And also you work with the BBC, which is a really high level. So on your CV to have something that's been on the BBC for your first like port of call is amazing.
And most of my peers have also applied to It's My Shout or been through It's My Shout as well. So it's kind of a rite of passage, I think, for a lot of Welsh filmmakers. I directed another short film called Fun Day, which was selected for Raindance Film Festival. And I'm now on the set of my first feature film, Convenience. So, yeah, it's just taken further steps forward, really.
After I left the It's My Shout scheme and I was lucky enough to win Best Director, it was really helpful because it then all of a sudden put me in front of the film agency. So when the film agency had another scheme, they asked me if I would like to fit in a pitch. And that led on to me for doing another short, and that short went down quite well.
What are you doing? What's happened?
So then that was started building me a portfolio to show investors for my feature.
Let me go.
No!
Elfie Hopkins, my latest feature, is going to cinemas next week, which is great. And that's really my first, like, it's my first foot in the door. Kind of like It's My Shout was my first foot in the door to short films, Elfie's my first foot in the door to features.
But every director needs a strong crew of talented people in every department, from camera and sound to makeup, costume and set design. Helen O'Leary was a trainee in the set design and props department back in 2008.
I hadn't considered TV or film before. I'd set my sights on doing stuff in theatre. So it was quite a good experience for me, and an eye-opener, really, doing this It's My Shout. The production designer, who was our mentor of the art department, gave us one script as a little project each to be in charge of. So we'd have to do the breakdown for that script and then do the prop sourcing and then, on the day, be in charge as our, you know, standby art director. The Bulb, or Egg In, which was my little baby, was about a boy in school who was getting bullied, but as part of a science project, they were each given a plant to look after.
Got here.
Tin't sure.
The plant was like the hero prop in this. So we had loads of these, but loads and loads of repeats. Piled them up in the van, got them down there, opened the van door, and then we're like, boom. So someone's board had landed on top of these plants and flattened them, so we had to do some quick repair jobs on them, and we brought them back to life. Not magically, but with a bit of wire. It was quite hairy for me, that experience, because a few things did go wrong, but got it sorted. And and I think that particular shoot was the one where I thought, yeah, I really want to do this, I like this, good feeling. So since It's My Shout, I've worked on Upstairs, Downstairs and Doctor Who in trainee capacity, but since then did Standby Props and Pobl last summer, and now they've asked me back this time round to be art directing, which is what I'm doing now.
I hope the microphone is down there, so we just have to make sure that we can't see anything down there.
Specifically for me, It's My Shout just gave me a little bit of insight into the industry and put me in a position where I could meet other people who are already doing it, and then subsequently, it did open up more opportunities further down the line.
Chris Jacoby was a camera trainee in 2011.
I'm a bit worried about the reflection because I can't see.
I was at uni doing film production, so I mean, I'd concentrated on cinematography throughout the 3 years, so I knew that's what I wanted to go into. Uni doesn't really prepare you for what you need to learn when you're on set, so all of that comes from experiences in the professional world. I think last year, the opening of Sweet 16, there was a very complicated shot where the main character is writing what she wants for her 16th birthday, and we were on top of a roof, it was dark, you know, we had it lit, so we had this really complicated shot that started over her shoulder, onto her hand, pull up, pull away, and I was the one that had to do that shot. And I mean, it took about 3 takes to get it right, and I think we got it, and I mean, that was a really, really good experience because that was the first film we did. And you know, it was kind of like me sort of controlling the shot and getting it right, and satisfaction of a very, very complicated shot that paid off and it was used in the film.
From the outset, I've firmly been of the opinion that the product needs to be as good as you can possibly make it. It's not enough just to give people an experience. They need to have an experience that results in something that they can take pride in, and we can all take huge pride in what we've delivered over the years.
This year, It's My Shout won its third BAFTA Cymru Award.
So what's the birthday girl want to do today then?
And the winner is Sweet 16.
First of all, I'd like to thank Roger and Kylie from It's My Shout Productions. BAFTA Short Scheme that made this all possible.
And this summer, another 6 short films have been made. Chris Jacoby has returned as cinematographer for 3 of them.
My role on this year is director of photography, so I'm in charge of lighting, camera angles, camera work, and obviously training or aiding the trainees I have on each shoot. It's my first proper paid job as a DOP, and as well, it's getting broadcast national, so it's nice to have that pressure to know you got up your game.
And all of this year's films were premiered at a special event. Each year since the scheme began, a premiere and award ceremony has recognised the trainees' hard work and talent. But never before has it been held in the iconic setting of Cardiff Bay's Wales Millennium Centre, to an audience of 1,500 trainees and supporters.
10 years ago, I remember the first awards event. It was in a day, actually, in the Odeon Cinema in Bridgend. It went through the Grand Pavilion then in Porthcawl, and tonight here in the Wales Millennium Centre. And it's great to see so many young people from around Wales taking part.
To be in the Millennium Centre, such, well, an iconic building where so many amazing artists have performed, says that, well, not only has it got an amazing presence, but it also has a great potential for the future.
For me, it was a bit of a roller coaster of emotion. There was humour, there was such talent, and every bit of the production. It was great that I was awarding sound engineer.
And the winner is Joseph Barker.
Oh, the best, I don't know what to say, I'm speechless, thanks very much.
Yeah. For me, these young people, every part of the team has got to be recognised. I would also, you know, as a minister, feel that this is a really important scheme development I want to support.
It's brilliant because 2 years ago, this is what got me into Stella, and it gave me the best opportunity in life. Yeah.
It's fantastic, yeah. Oh, it's great, and, you know, there's verification that it's a scheme that finds and nurtures new talent. She's great. I wish it was going when I started out.
The future is bright, but I promise you the future is yours. So be strong and go and chase it. And well done, everybody, tonight.
Mm. I'm presenting Best Supporting Actor. What are you presenting?
Best Actor.
Well, that tells you something, doesn't it? That tells you something.
I think the talent's always been there, but of course it's the opportunity for the talent to show itself. It's all very well having talented people, but if they never have the chance to actually show how talented they are, then of course they're lost. But it's because of It's My Shout that that talent has the chance to flourish.
Tonight, a special achievement award recognises that talent in Aneirin Bernard. Since leaving It's My Shout, he has won a Laurence Olivier Award for his role in the West End production of Spring Awakening, and has starred in Hollywood films including Mariah Mundy and The Midas Box. For BBC Four, he played photographer David Bailey in We'll Take Manhattan.
That's it. Done.
This is a bit mental. I feel a bit young to be taking one of these awards. I feel like I need another 50 years before I can stand here and hold it, but I will treasure it. And it's overwhelming. Knowing where this come from Roger, Mr. B, as the pupils know him. Without him, I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing, and a lot of other people wouldn't be doing it either. And this night here wouldn't be here for definite. So a personal thank you, Roger.
And a special award for Roger recognises how much he has done to develop a scheme that continues to enrich the lives and careers of young people across Wales.
I hope that everybody here joins with me in celebrating what all these people have done. Thanks to everybody who's come. This is obviously one of the nights of my life, and I hope that you've shared in something which is hopefully going to be important to all these young people.
I think, you know, I hope it will grow, but I hope that it will just devour the UK. Let's get everyone involved.